Hello everybody and welcome to episode number 34 on Monday the 6th of July 2009. My name's Steve Layton and yep, thank you very much for joining me again. First of all, before we get onto the mugs and all of those things, is the Glastonbury one from last week. If you haven't seen it, you must go back and see it. It's very short, concise, to the point. That was something to do with being petrified security. We're going to come and beat me up. But great, great feedback on it. I've really enjoyed reading your emails on it. And if you haven't emailed me about it, why not? Why aren't you talking to me? Why do you hate me so much? Email address, same as normal. Pop it up below. So, right, mug. Mug I'm going to talk about today is a Widnes Vikings mug. Yesterday I had my rugby league cherry popped and I went to my first ever rugby league game, which I enjoyed immensely. The kind of Widnes who I ended up supporting because that's who we were seeing and that's who everybody else was with, won 70-4, I think it was. Very high scoring, very one-sided, but a great game. Just while I'm talking, I just want to set this on its way because it's going to take a little bit of time to get it done. So just bear with me a second while I do this, and I will tell you more about it in a little while. Okay, there we go, that's working like a treat. So, yeah, thank you very much for Tim. Tim Holmes, who is the community kind of coach for Widnes Vikings, who has very kindly given me the mug, which is hot off the press. These aren't even for sale yet, and I was able to get one yesterday, so I was really excited. And thank you very much for the tickets and the hospitality, and thanks very much to Kate as well, who looked after us amazingly. Ferried us from pub to pub and to train stations. Nearly bowled over then, to train stations and the like, so she was an absolute star and thank you very, very much. Okay, coffee we're going to talk about today. Coffee is called Cuba Serrano Superior. It's a coffee that hit our cupping table and we didn't know so much about. It's another one of those ones, unfortunately. But what it does mean is the cupping table doesn't tell any lies. It doesn't have any expectations. It doesn't kind of know. It's what you taste, and if it tastes good, then it's, you know, it's in and it's great. And that's what happened with this coffee. I believe I scored it a 90, which is incredibly high for a Cuban coffee, from my experience in the past. So, very excited to have it. I don't know what varietal it is. I think it's Typica. From the importers, they think it's Typica. From looking at it and tasting it, I believe it's Typica, but we're not 100% sure. So, sorry, just going to carry on with that again. It's harvested between October, November, December. Sun-dried, fairly confident it's sun-dried because it's very rare to have mechanical drying in Cuba. And it's grown in a region called the Sierra Monstra region, which is to the east of Cuba. So, how am I brewing it? Well, you can see in the little corner down there that I've got an Ibrick going. An Ibrick is a style of brewing which is kind of used a lot in Turkey, Yemen, that kind of region around there. It's ground very fine. I'm just going to show you a picture now of the grind. You see it's ground.